Hi, my name is David.
My name is Millie.
I'm Jay.
My name is Jordan.
And my name is Adam.
Hi, my name is Safia.
My name is Sanchez Smith.
My name is Sarah.
My name is Tyrone.
My name is Oliver.
I am 15 years old.
I'm 17 years old.
I'm 19 years old.
And I'm 17 years old.
Being the youth manager at Hackney Quest, I've worked over the last year with a group of 10 young people to train up to get to this point. And having the 10, you know, bringing them away for 2 weeks to a country, some of them have never even been abroad before, so it's just such a massive experience for them.
Well, joining this program because I wanted to give to others and I wanted to help the young people out here.
The goals I set myself was to be more confident and to be more confident around people.
Confidence was like one of them. To be able to like speak in a big group of people, like I never do that. So I had to build my confidence slowly. But every day, like every single day, somebody's telling me like, yeah, your confidence is improving and stuff like that.
I just want to inspire them. I know that, and let them know that they can reach for bigger things.
And I would like to leave like a legacy from Hackney Quest.
My goal is to like go back to the UK, be grateful and everything. Just to actually take on board what I see.
Challenges I didn't expect within group dynamics and within the tag rugby, the excitement of it and the ways that is helping our young people that we've brought develop is kind of what I hoped for and expected.
For the past 2 days, I'm on my third day now. I've been teaching tag rugby for two-hour sessions every day to two different schools.
It's been very long, very tiring, but I think that we're doing well.
At first we was a bit rusty, but as we get along, as we know the game's a bit more better, if everything's running smoothly.
I saw huge development in the young people, the growth, not just as tag rugby coaches, but also as individuals, and broadening their horizons and experiencing something totally different that perhaps they would never experience before.
This is the last day of training here. With the first lot of schools, and yeah, tomorrow's the tournament, and all the schools have been doing really well.
Today, when we first picked the team, some of them were a bit disappointed and upset, but then we managed to get the best ones out of the school, and they're really happy about it, and they're really excited for tomorrow.
I'm looking forward to the tournament because I really want to see who wins, and I want to see how well our groups do individually, and see, and it will kind of give us like an insight of how hard we worked. Like we know how hard we work, but we'll see the end product to see who actually wins.
Walking in power! Walking in power! I live a life of faith.
The Huguenots have had a huge impact on the kids and all the schools that we've worked with. There have been some great relationships built and they've all had lots and lots of fun. And I know that the kids that have been coached will carry on playing tag rugby.
So next week I'm looking forward to going to like the orphanage and doing community projects.
I think this place is amazing. It's so peaceful here. All the kids just seem to have a home and be happy.
I stay in a house with like other children because there's orphans, and how the place is set up is that there's different households with one mother. Yeah, and it's just been so lovely.
The mothers are like mothers back at home because they look after you, help you with homework.
So I'm at the Kids Pioneer School, which is actually run by the Kids of Africa Orphanage that myself, the Huguenots, have been staying at. As you can see, it's such an amazing building here. Like compared to some of the schools here in Entebbe, this is definitely one of a lot high quality. It's right by Lake Victoria, which is just stunning, beautiful views.
Yeah, I think I'll try and carry on tag rugby coaching, and also it will help me appreciate more what I've got home as well.
Like I've become like more mature, more understanding of how the world is.
I think it's made me mentally stronger because it's not like you can get a train home if you're upset or a bus, we're on the other side of the world.
Seeing them shine and hearing about it each day, about what they did and what they've learned, and seeing the children that they've had impact on has just been amazing.